Nelson, DS Greg, DC Carver. I remember you from before. You took your time.
A couple of uniformed officers did call earlier to take details of the burglary.
Well, that's a comfort. I'll tell you what, the council still haven't fixed this door from the last time it happened. Rosie?
You all right, love?
Are you okay?
The hell do they
want? Oh, come on, Pat. You can't blame them.
You make me sick. What are you crawling up to them for? You're always crawling up to somebody.
I'll make us a cup of tea.
That's your answer for everything, isn't it?
Sorry.
Stop apologising. It's them that should be apologising to us. There's the serial number and everything. Not that it'll be of any use to your mind.
Any other security markings on the video?
No, I didn't see the point.
Anything else go?
I'll tell you what's gone, shall I? Faith in the police. That's what's missing round here.
In court, you'll just be asked to list the crimes the Collier brothers have committed since landing themselves back on the estate.
I know the procedure, but do you think it'll be that simple?
The civil court's not much different from the criminal courts. I'm sure you'll do a grand job.
Well, after all the work we put in, let's hope the judge agrees, or we might never drive the Colliers off this estate. Morning, Ron.
Andrew. Laura. Thanks for coming back to pick me up.
My pleasure.
So this is it then. The big day.
We shouldn't count our chickens, Ron. In 5 years as a council enforcement officer, I've seen plenty of orders of possession fail.
Listen, if we can pull this one off, we'll have all my residents putting out the banners.
Notwithstanding that the Collier brothers are just two of our problems.
Oh, well, two down, one to go, eh?
You remember our last burglary? Rosie got the contents of her bag back in the end, after they'd ripped them to shreds and poked them back through the letterbox. I ask you, what sort of person would do a thing like that?
If I ever get my hands on them, I'd make sure they never became a father, and that's for sure.
Now, who are you talking about?
The Collier brothers, of course. They're the ones who do all the crimes on this estate, aren't they?
Well, unless we catch them at it.
Either them or that Darren Oakley on the other side of the estate. Everybody knows his reputation.
Morning, Mr. Oakley. Very nice day for it.
Is it?
We'd like to ask you where you were at about 9 o'clock this morning.
Ask away.
Well, where were you?
Here.
You got witnesses?
No.
Because we have reason to think that you were on the other side of the estate.
Well, you'd think wrong then, wouldn't you?
Where a burglary took place.
Why are you prats always picking on me, eh?
It's another new car.
So what?
That's very nice. Must have cost you a few quid. You working, are you?
It was a present from me granny.
She got a coffin and I got myself a motor. And what is this, some sort of personal vendetta?
You just bored out of your tiny minds.
Nah. No, we're just doing our job, Mr. Oakley.
You're barking up the wrong lamppost.
Yeah? What if I told you that you were seen on the other side of the estate this morning?
I'd say that nobody on this estate saw me doing nothing. If they say they did, they're liars.
Rosie, sure it's the Colliers that are behind this.
Well, on this estate, it is either Oakley or the Colliers. But I think even the Colliers would draw a line at committing a burglary on the day they're in court.
What's that for, then?
It's a court action to have them excluded from the estate. Something we've been working on with the council and your local community leader.
Ron Pearcy. I know him. He does his best, like, but how's this going to work when everything else has failed?
You keep throwing mud against the wall and eventually something will stick.
2 years you've had to sort them out. It's a bit of a tired record, isn't it?
Well, you know the problem. Trying to get a witness on this estate is like getting blood from a stone.
Aye, that's our fault, is it? You know, it doesn't matter that my missus and kids have been threatened with a Stanley knife. And I've had me car kicked in and me front door smashed down just because we might have seen something. You open your mouth in this place, you're liable to lose your tongue. So don't tell me about witnesses.
Of course, with no jury, the whole case depends on how the judge views it. They're not too keen when it comes to splitting up families.
Well, maybe Andy and Nigel Collier should have thought of that before they decided to terrorise the estate.
Talk of the devils.
Excuse me.
What I got?
Chocolate. We'll have a bit of chocolate. Sorry.
Thanks, mate, love.
We ain't taking this lying down, you know. I think you can go around slinging people out of their houses.
I'll remind you, your lease with the council is for you and your husband, Mrs. Collier, and that does not include your sons.
You say my sons can't come and visit me?
2 years is hardly visiting.
Well, where are we supposed to live, then?
You should have thought of that before you came back from Spain, my friend.
Tenerife, actually. Not that you'd know the difference. It ain't our fault we lost our jobs.
Well, it certainly isn't ours. You've made everybody's life hell on that estate.
Everybody? But you can't speak for everyone, can you?
I think you'll find there's a virtually unanimous opinion on the subject.
Don't see people queuing up to give evidence against my son. So, where are they all, then?
We feel we've got all the evidence we need.
Feel? You don't know the meaning of the word. You know what it's like to have people slagging off your family all the time, do you?
Yeah, being old Billy probably does.
I think we'll terminate this conversation. See you in court, lads.
Yeah, like we're really scared of the courts.
Prat.
Yeah, I'm T.S. Craig from Sutton Hill. A flat across the way was burgled earlier. Have you seen any?
No, I haven't been talking.
Sure.
I'm sure.
All right, okay. Thank you. Yeah.
See you, Shirley.
Oh, excuse me, love. Can I have a word? I'm DC Carver, Sun Hill. A house got burgled over there earlier. I don't suppose you saw...
No, sorry. I live on the other side.
Well, you may have heard then about our clampdown on persistent offenders.
Yeah, and I know what happens to people around here who spout their mouths off.
Look, we're getting it sorted. We're having them kicked off the estate.
Look, I can't stop. I've got to feed the baby.
But if you do know something, then we can look after you. I'll make sure of it. That's a promise.
Not here. Down the road. Wally's?
Well, the cafe, yeah, I know it.
Right.
Well, what time?
About an hour.
In a period of the last 23 months, Your Honour, we've been called to Mr. and Mrs. Collier's address at the Maycroft estate on no less than 63 occasions, mainly as a result of complaints from neighbours about loud music, abusive language, threatening behaviour, fighting and acts of criminal damage. And Nigel Collier has been charged and convicted on offences of burglary, 3 attempted burglaries and 4 counts of criminal damage. His brother Andrew has also been convicted of burglary, attempted burglary, criminal damage and indecent exposure. All of these crimes being committed on the Maycroft estate.
Thank you, Inspector.
I must ask you, Inspector, have my clients served sentence for the offences which you have just listed?
Periods of probation and community service have been served for the offences, yes.
So their debt to society has been properly and fully paid?
I'm hardly qualified to comment on the processes of sentencing, Your Honour.
Or is it your opinion, Inspector, that the sentences were perhaps too lenient?
Yes.
Well, I put it to you, Inspector, that my clients have been maliciously persecuted by officers of Sun Hill Police.
That is not true.
Who, disgruntled by what they perceive to be lenient sentences, have instigated a vendetta culminating in this hearing today. Now, is that not the case?
No, Your Honour. The application for this order was instigated by the local council.
With your full support?
Yes. With our full and total support.
Same again.
Oh, no, thanks, sir.
Here you go. Tea?
Yeah.
2 teas, please, love. Look, I really appreciate this. It's not many people who talk to us.
You mean no one, don't you?
Well,
I wouldn't be if it wasn't for my sister. She's had her flat done over 8 times now. But do you mind if
I... Oh, help yourself.
The thing is, what really made me sick, the last...
Thank you.
The last time she got burgled, she didn't even have nothing worth nicking. So they poured bleach all over her house and smashed up her daughter's doll's house.
And you think the people that did that did the one this morning?
Well, no, he did.
You sound very sure.
At my sister's place, someone saw Darren Oakley legging it. Well, at least that's what they told my sister anyway.
So you saw Darren Oakley at this morning's burglary?
No. There's a bloke lives opposite me, Alex Brunger. I saw Oakley go in there this morning. I've seen him going in and out quite a few times recently.
Sorry, I don't get the connection.
Well, it's obvious, isn't it?
What?
He must be taking the stolen stuff there. The videos and what have you.
Well, because you saw him go into this bloke's flat.
In and out with bin liners. I don't know what you make of that, but...
Look, right, he does sound a bit unusual.
Unusual? He's hardly taking out the rubbish. Look, I can't tell you anymore. There's the address.
Look, I need to take a statement.
No chance.
Look, I don't even know your name.
No, you don't.
Look. We can do Oakley the same as we're doing the Colliers, but only if people...
Look, you get rid of them, and I'll help you get rid of Oakley. You've got the information. Take it or leave it.
point, Jim. I mean, she wouldn't even give her name and address.
I've already told you, Sarge. She doesn't want to get involved.
I'm not sure I do. Not without a search warrant.
Look, Sarge, if this bloke Brunger is a mate of Oakley's, then he's got me bed.
Darren, is that you?
Sorry?
Who is it?
Mr. Brunger. It's DC Carver, DS Gregg, Sun Hill. Can we have a word, please?
Yeah. You better come in. What's this about then?
Mr. Brunger, we're investigating a burglary, a series of burglaries.
Burglaries? Can't help you there.
Do you live here alone, Mr. Brunger?
Since my wife died.
Mr. Brunger, do you know a young man called Darren Oakley who lives on the estate?
No, I'll keep myself to myself.
So when you answered the door, why did you call me Darren?
Did I? Probably said Karen. Mills on wheels.
Has anyone ever asked you to store anything here, Mr. Brunger?
No.
And you definitely don't know anyone by the name of Oakley?
No.
All right, Mr. Brunger. If we need to talk to you again, we'll be in touch.
Oh, I'm sorry. Can I use your loo?
Yeah, on the right.
Sorry there.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Lovely, thanks. There is one last thing, though. I wonder if you'd give us permission to have a look around.
Well, I...
Unless you prefer us to get a search warrant, that is. If you wouldn't mind, Mr. Brunger.
Mr. Piercy, as chairperson of the Maycroft Estate Residents Association, I wonder if you could tell the court whether you received any complaints regarding the response.
Hundreds. Neighbors who've been threatened for asking them to turn down their music. Broken windows, graffiti, bonfires, swearing and shouting in the middle of the night, fighting. On one occasion, I was asked by their next door neighbor to have a word with them concerning a rowdy party which had run out of control. They'd broken down the fence and ransacked the garden. They pulled up every single living plant.
And were criminal proceedings ever instigated on these matters?
No. I believe they were too frightened to call the police. But when I spoke to the colliers about it, they squirted me with lighter fuel and threatened to set me on fire.
Your Honor, these crimes were certainly never attributed to my clients.
That is so, Your Honor. Mr. Piercy, in the past 2 years, how would you describe life on the Maycroft estate?
It's been a living nightmare, Your Honor.
So, Mr. Brunger, you understand that you've been arrested for receiving stolen goods, and you've understood the caution?
Yeah.
Mr. Brunger, can you explain how this video recorder came to be in your wardrobe?
I found it.
When?
I don't know, a couple of days ago.
And where did you find it exactly?
By the big wheelie bins, the bottom of the house.
So why didn't you report it to the police?
I was going to. Honest, I was. I put it in the wardrobe for safekeeping. I was going to hand it in later.
Why should we believe you?
I'm telling you the truth.
Mr. Brunger, this video recorder which you claim you found 2 days ago was stolen from a flat on the Maycroft estate this morning. Now, how do you explain that? Did you steal it?
No, I'm not a criminal.
Well, let me help you then. Did someone bring it to your flat and ask you to look after it for them?
I told you I found it.
Do you know anybody called Darren Oakley?
No.
You sure about that?
Of course I'm sure.
Okay. We'll leave you there for the moment. Interview terminated at 12:47. I'd like you to pick a tape and sign there.
All right, Jim, we'll see you upstairs.
Yeah. Cheers, Sarge.
What happens now, then?
He'll be released, pending further inquiries, and later on, you'll probably be charged with handling stolen goods. But you haven't been too clever, have you? We do know where the video came from. Oakley was seen going into your flat.
I won't go to prison, will I?
Well, if the likes of Oakley and the colliers aren't sent down, I doubt if the judge will put you away. But you could make life much easier on yourself by coming clean. You're scared to death of them, aren't you?
Yeah.
We're gonna have them. The Colliers first, then Oakley. I'm gonna prove it to you.
Both Andrew and Nigel Collier are currently residing at their parents' home.
Is it not reasonable, Miss Bishop, that the respondents live with their parents?
The property concerned belongs to the council, and a tenancy agreement exists with Mr. and Mrs. Collier for their sole occupation. Technically, Andrew and Nigel are squatters.
Would you not say that that is rather harsh?
I would point out, Your Honour, that the Colliers did for several years reside in a family home supplied by the council. But when their sons left the country, Mr. and Mrs. Collier applied for a two-person flat. This we provided.
And in the council's view, Miss Bishop, this fact would exclude one's children from coming to visit, would it?
With respect, the respondents have been staying with their parents for the past 2 years.
And would the council be prepared to offer the respondents alternative accommodation?
They're entitled to put their names onto the council waiting list. But we're of the opinion that 2 years is an adequate period in which to secure alternative housing for themselves.
So are you saying that the council would not be prepared to rehouse them?
They would be a low priority case.
So in effect, they could be made homeless?
Possibly. But no housing application has ever been filed by them. Presumably, it doesn't bother them.
Well, I think that is a matter of pure conjecture, don't you, Miss Bishop?
So you've got no witnesses and no forensic.
I know, but I do have the video recorder and I have got Brunger.
He's never going to turn Oakley in. His brief will tell him to plead guilty to handling and he'll walk away with a slap wrist.
Unless I can persuade him otherwise.
All right, how are you going to do that? Thumb screws and hot irons? Or sweet talk and a bunch of pink carnations?
We'll see.
Mr. Collier, can you please tell the court the circumstances which have resulted in you staying at your parents' flat?
Me and my brother got made redundant about 2 years ago. Since then, we've tried every possibility to get back into the workplace. Applied for jobs, been to interviews, work placement schemes, all sorts. But if there's no work about...
And what was your former job?
Me and my brother were sales executives.
Good jobs?
Yeah, really good.
So these stories, such as we've heard today, which have been circulated and propagated regarding you and your brother, can you think of any reason why they exist?
Tell the truth, most of the people on the estate are lucky if they get a week's caravanning down the Isle of Shepney. We've travelled, been places. They're jealous of us.
And regarding your previous transgressions, you've been willing to admit to those?
Yeah, totally. I admit we've had a few parties, a few games of football on the street. But where else can you do it? There's nothing on the estate.
And have you served your sentences for your transgressions?
Totally. I admit, if we've done wrong, then we've paid for it. But I don't see why we should be driven away from our mum and dad.
Yes, quite. Thank you.
Mr. Collier, just a point I'd like to clarify. Could you please tell the court why you left your job as a timeshare salesman in Tenerife?
Don't know what you mean.
It's perfectly simple. Why did you leave your salesman's job and leave Tenerife?
Well, I got made redundant.
Made redundant? Or sacked? Think about it.
Redundant? But what's that got to do with anything?
You were caught stealing from your employer, weren't you?
No.
The police were called in and you and your brother were deported from Tenerife, weren't you?
This ain't relevant.
You may as well answer my question. It is a fact that is on record.
It was a cock-up.
I put it to you that the only cock-up was that you were caught stealing then and that you've been caught lying now. And that this image you portray of being some kind of victim is totally false.
Yeah, well, people wind us up.
The only people that have been wound up, Mr. Collier, are the victims that you have taunted and persecuted and threatened and intimidated. The residents of the Maycroft estate are the victims in this case, not you or your brother.
Sorry to disturb your break, sir.
What can I do you for, Jim?
Well, I wonder if we got it. The possession order against the Collier boys.
I got until 4 o'clock to get the gear out of the flat. We'll be going down for the last goodbyes to make sure there's no trouble.
This will be more popular than the Olympics.
Well, let's hope not. I don't want this turning into a circus.
No, sir. Of course not. Can I come in? You all right? You seem a bit edgy. Did you think it was him coming back?
Can't say, can I?
I've got some news that might interest you. The Colliers. We're having them kicked off the estate. They won't be allowed to set foot in this place.
Not a lot of good to me, is it?
Well, not directly, no. But if we can do it to the Colliers, we can do it to Oakley.
If I make a statement, you mean?
It would help. Especially if everyone else round here spilt the beans on him as well.
You could have him kept away if I do what you say.
It would be another nail in his coffin.
How do I know you'll get him off my back?
If you want proof, I can give you proof.
All right, you all know the form. We let the bailiffs do their job, serve the notices on the Colliers, and then we all go home.
Looks like we might be needed after all.
Get this lot shifted, will you? Now, come on, ladies and gentlemen, this is not a sideshow.
You could have fooled me.
Now, come on, folks, this isn't helping at all. Move right back. Move away, madam, please. Come on,
please. Come on,
right
back, please.
Thank you.
Move back, please. Move back, please.
I told you so.
Excuse me.
Just hold it there a minute, okay?
You stay out of here.
Now, don't be silly, Mrs. Collier.
You have no right.
We have every right, and you know it. I'm going to be arresting you for criminal damage. You've got it. Start again, shall I?
You enjoying the show?
Bit of a laugh. Makes a change to see the police doing something.
I keep watching. You might learn something.
Stay where you are! Just stay there!
Stop
you! Take it easy.
Andrew Collier.
Too late, pal. It's been served. Now move. You understand what the court order means? You come anywhere near this estate again, you'll be arrested.
Right, sir. Fine, thank you, Jim.
Is that proof enough for you?
All right, yeah.
Well, how about a statement?
Yeah, I'll be making a statement. Of course, I ain't frightened of you no more.
Well, Darren, what can I say?
Shut up, you. All of you.
Have a nice day, Darren. Yeah. It's your turn next.